Susan Pitzer with Tupperware, and I want to show you a really quick way that you can cook your ribs in the microwave using the Tupperware microwave pressure cooker. And I've already put the ribs in here. I've got the country style pork ribs, and I seasoned those, and then I've added some liquid. You can add broth or water depending on what you're gonna do. Some of the little ones don't like barbecue, so I'm gonna do plain, and then we'll add the barbecue at the end for those who do like the barbecue. But simply you put your ribs in there, cover it with your liquid up to the little fill line, and then we're gonna lock the top on. And it's got these little arrows that will match up to the handle, or not. And we've got these little arrows here, and we're gonna match that up on the sides. And that will actually twist and lock on. And we're gonna snap this down. Now, once that starts cooking, this little pressure valve is gonna pop up whenever everything's under pressure. Once it's cooked for 30 minutes, that will be raised, and then we're gonna have to let it set and pressure down about 5 to 10 minutes. And then we'll be able to see the contents inside. But I'm gonna put this in the microwave for 30 minutes and I'll be back. All right, and I just used a couple of different seasonings, and you can put whatever kind of seasoning you like on the meat and whatever kind of broth, or if you wanna just put liquid, you know, water on top. But we'll be back in 30 minutes and see what we have. Okay, we're down to the final seconds on the pressure cooker with the ribs in it in the microwave. We've had it in for 30 minutes. And I want to show you what to expect whenever your timer goes off for your pressure cooker and see how that works. We can hear some noise, which is a good sign that it's working properly. When you take that out, you'll see that valve is popped up, and then we've got the pressure valve on this side is also releasing steam. And you just simply want to set that aside until that pressure's down, kind of unlike on a turkey where the timer comes up and it's done. Well, this is done, but you want that to go back down before you open, before it's safe to open the pressure cooker. So we'll give it about 5 to 10 minutes, and I'll be back and show you the contents. Okay, we've pressured down. As you can see, the valve has dropped all the way down, so we're gonna be safe to open this. And when you go to open it, you just simply unlock and then twist the cover back off. Lift that, lift it away, because there's gonna be some steam. Smells really good, and I'll show you what we have. Looks really nice, and let's see how tender these are. Oh wow, they just kind of fall apart with your fork. I don't know if you can see that, but super tender. See how close they just kind of fall apart, and so they're ready to serve with your barbecue sauce or seasonings, whatever you like. And that was 30 minutes. If you ever have a larger quantity and you feel like your meat's not tender enough that first time, you can always, once it's pressured down, check it, and then you can give it another 10-15 minutes to complete it. But this looks perfect, so we're ready to go. And then you can serve it with your favorite sauce or salt and pepper, however you like to season your meats. Took 30 minutes total cook time in the microwave. I didn't have to sit there and watch it. And it's amazing, super tender and ready to go. But the Tupperware pressure cooker for the microwave. And if you have any questions, if I can help in any way, please let me know. Have a great day.